Hey guys, this is Matt from ABICOR Binzel. Let's talk about your wire liners, one of the most critical pieces of your MIG gun and a super important piece to maintaining a smooth wire feed. Your wire liners are one of the more difficult parts of your MIG gun to maintain, but it is super important for an efficient welding operation. You'd be really surprised how many people don't even know how to change their wire liner out. Lucky if you're one of those people, we have a how-to video on our YouTube channel that will show you how to change your wire liner out. Just takes a few minutes. You can do it with any welding machine, so please check that out after you see this video. So let's talk about your liner size. There is a debate over how large your wire liner's inner diameter should be in relation to your wire size. There is the belief that using a larger wire liner will provide less resistance if you're going to use a smaller wire. So let's say you use a 035 wire and you also use an 052 wire. Well, maybe we just use a 5262 liner so you could fit both those wires through. The smaller wire, like an 035, it has less column strength, so it can wander inside that larger liner. It can buckle under pressure. It also can cause the liner to wear prematurely because it's rubbing excessively against the liner. And it can also lead to some serious maintenance issues like bird nesting, and then also even jamming inside the liner. These are both really maintenance intensive things to have happen. Causes a lot of downtime, wastes a lot of wire, especially the jamming. You really don't want something like that to happen, and you can generally avoid it by just using the right size liner in relation to your wire. Diligent maintenance on your wire liner is another important consideration that you want to make. It's a really easy process to do. You should do it after every spool change on your welding machine. Just when you take that torch offline to do that spool change, remove the wire obviously from the liner. Also remove the contact tip and the diffuser from the front end. Use a compressed air liner, put it up against the collet, blow that compressed air through the liner, and then you'll extend the service life of the liner as a result. Let's start with steel, which is gonna be the most widely used wire liner material you're gonna see out there, and for really good reason. Steel has a really good balance of flexibility and rigidity and performance, and it's also a very cost-effective option. Can, however, pose problems with stainless steel wire or a chromoly alloy. Reason being is that kind of wire can produce excessive wear and increased resistance on the wire liner itself. One tip on that, now while we're on the subject of resistance, is a lot of operators will try to overcome resistance problems on the wire liner by trying to clamp down tighter on the drive rolls on your welding machine. Not a practice that we would recommend, mostly because it can distort the wire. And then also, instead of keeping the wire from slipping inside the wire liner, you can actually pierce the wire through the coil and through the cable in the event of a burn back, which can cause a really big safety hazard. So definitely don't want to try to do that. You also have other wire types like aluminum and silicon bronze. Those are also not considered really good fits for a steel wire liner. Reason being is because those wires are very soft and are a little bit more delicate, we should say, for lack of a better term. And so what happens inside of a steel liner is that there'll be a higher level of resistance. There'll also, with those wires, can cause abrasion inside of the liner. And then the steel liner can also introduce contaminants into your weld as a result of welding with those kinds of wires. So definitely don't recommend using a steel liner if you're going to weld with those sorts of wires. I'd recommend one of the other materials. Another kind of steel liner that you'll see a lot is an insulated steel liner. It looks virtually identical from a standard steel liner, with the exception of this little laminate that you see kind of over the coils. And the reason for that is because of how the gas is introduced into your MIG gun. So with a steel liner, you're going to see a dedicated gas port, dedicated gas line through your MIG gun, and it's going to feed gas all the way to the front end. With an insulated steel liner, gas is actually introduced through your torch cable and around your wire liner. So this laminate actually works to protect your liner from having gas permeate through the coils and then purge out the back. Depending on your torch make and how it's made is going to dictate whether you use a standard steel liner or an insulated steel liner. So check with your MIG gun OEM. They'll have that answer for you. It's very clear based on how the torch is built. Beyond the steel liners, which are, you know, very cost effective and very popular, there's also a variety of plastic liner options that you can use as well. They all look very similar, but let's go over how each of them are a little bit different. So first one here, we have a polyamide liner. This is a carbon-filled nylon material, really good for low temperature applications. So short circuit air cooled, or if you're gonna do push-pull welding with a push-pull gun with a light gauge aluminum, or also if you're gonna weld with that silicone bronze or that stainless steel wire that isn't necessarily well suited for a steel wire liner. This would be a really good fit for you. Right next to this is a combi PA, so it's a combination of a polyamide liner with this little brass spiral here attached to the end of it, and this brass spiral is a really important piece of this. If you're going to go slightly higher in your parameters, this actually is the piece that helps with that current transfer, so you can make sure you're getting to the parameters that you want. Again, really good fit for silicon bronze, for aluminum, and also for push-pull welding as well. This is the liner that you definitely want to be using for those kinds of applications. Okay, so after this, the combi PA liner, this red liner right here, this is a PTFE liner. It's otherwise known as a TEFLON liner. Now, TEFLON liners have a higher melting temperature than a polyamide or a combi PA. So really good for these higher parameter application. You can run this liner all the way up to the front end of your torch and it'll be able to withstand the higher heat. So it's really good resistance characteristics in that regard. Also really slick liner, I can feel it in my hand. So it has really good abrasion protection characteristics as well as promotes a really smooth wire feed. One thing to keep in mind, really with any of these plastic liners, but for Teflon it's especially true, you really want to inspect the leading edge of your wire prior to insertion. Make sure there's no burring or abnormality with that wire, because you don't want to have a scar inside of your wire liner, or really accelerate the wear of the liner and cause it to fail a lot faster than it normally should. You can also move up to a carbon PTFE liner that's literally translates to a carbon Teflon liner. These are Teflon liners that are infused with carbon, and why that's done is because it gives you even a higher temperature resistance and better wear protection than a standard Teflon liner. These are also really good liners to use for notoriously difficult to feed wires, ones with complex compositions or that things like steel or even polyamide liners have difficulty handling. Things like stainless steel flux core wires, another example, or aluminum wires like ER5356. There's also a high density PTFE. This is also known as molecular weight PTFE or molecular weight Teflon. This has similar melting point to a carbon PTFE liner, but it has an even longer service life. Also, in terms of the wire types you can use, it can really feed any wire very easily and very well. So whether it's soft wire, stiff wire, or abrasive wire, this high density PTFE liner is gonna be able to handle that in all likelihood. And again, if you're looking to really get the most life out of your liner and not change it very often, this is definitely the liner material you're looking at. So what's the best liner to use? It's really gonna depend on your parameters and your setup and your materials. Just make sure that you're doing the basics really well. You're mirroring up your wire size to your wire liner size, and also take a look at your wire liner material compared to the wire material that you're using. That's gonna get you the most life, not only out of your wire liner, but out of all of your consumables and your MIG gun in general. If you're looking for more welding tips and tricks, how-tos, or just general welding knowledge, you can always check out our blog, visit our YouTube channel, or you can of course visit us at binzel-abicor.com. This is Matt from ABICOR Binzel. Thanks so much for watching, guys. You have a great day.